Today I'm going to show you how to make this beautiful half double crochet infinity scarf. Hello crocheters and welcome back to the Crochet Depot. Today we are going to learn how to take the half double crochet stitch that we used the last video and we are going to make a half double crochet scarf. I do want to take some time to apologize for having such a long period of time between videos. As some of you know, I have my own boutique and most of the time I am creating things to sell in this boutique, and so I've been quite busy making custom orders, and so that's why I haven't been around. If you have not seen the half double crochet stitch video, please go back to that tutorial. It's the video right before this one. Go ahead and practice that stitch before you continue on with this video. If you're new to crochet and you need to learn the basics, please refer back to the beginning videos of this channel and it will teach you everything that you need to know. Okay, let's get started. The first thing you're going to need is a crochet hook, and I've chosen a size K, which is also a 6.5 millimeter hook. You're also going to need yarn. Any kind of yarn that you prefer, please make sure that it is a nice soft yarn. If you're going to make a scarf out of this, please make sure that the yarn you're using is wearable. For the yarn today, I have chosen Yarn B Soft Secret in the color Honey. You'll notice here when you pick your yarn, you're going to want to look at the net weight. This is 6 ounces or 300 yards. One skein of this should make an entire scarf without any problems. You will probably only need about 3/4 of the skein. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is make a slip knot. We are going to chain 22. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Now in the second chain from the hook, this is where the hook is right here, obviously. This is a loop on the hook. You want to go to the second chain from the hook. So here's the first chain below the hook. Here's the second chain. This is the chain we're going to use right here. You're going to start off with your half double crochet. Yarn over and make your first half double crochet in that stitch. Let's do it again. Yarn over, next chain space, make a half double crochet. Okay, let's do that again. Yarn over, make your next half double crochet in the next chain space. And just keep doing that in every chain space all the way to the end of the row. And that's all you're going to do. Make your half double crochets all the way to the end of the row, the same way I just did there, all the way to the end. Make your very last half double crochet into the last chain space, which is right here. And when we're finished, I will meet you back. Okay, so let's go ahead and make the very, very last half double crochet stitch in the very last space. Okay, and that's all you gotta do. Your row should look something similar to this. And now we're going to turn our work. First, we're going to chain two. One, two. Okay. Now you're going to turn your work around so that this side is facing this way. Okay. So you want your work to be facing this direction. You want your hook on this side. And we're going to continue the half double crochets. Yarn over, you're going to half double crochet into the very first chain space here. Okay, right here. This is very important if you want your work to continue straight up. If you go into the next space over here, your work is going to start to shift to the side, which you don't want. So go ahead and make your half double crochet right into that same space right there, just below, and pull through the first three loops and do that again into the next space. Half double crochet into that space there. Oops, grab that yarn again. Okay, and then just keep doing that. One half double crochet into every space all the way to the end of the row. Just like this. Okay, now continue and make a half double crochet in every single space all the way down to the end of the row. When you come to the very last stitch, I will show you where to put your last half double crochet, because on this particular row here and every row thereafter, the space where you need to put your stitch is going to be a little bit hidden. So I'm going to show you how to find it. I will meet you at the end. Okay, so you should be at the end of the row now. This right here is your very last stitch, and you're going to notice you have a V right here. Okay, there's a V right here, and you want to go up underneath that V. So you want to find your space, which is right here, and it's kind of hard to see it. There's a space right here. Okay, see that little hole? That's where you want to put your next half double crochet. It's right underneath that V stitch. Okay, so go right inside that space right there, up underneath the V stitch. Make sure you get both the top and the bottom. Make sure you get this one and this one right up underneath there. Okay, and then pull your yarn through and make that last half double crochet. Perfect. Now you're going to do the exact same thing with the next row as we did with this row. I want you to chain two and then turn your work. And now we're going to make another half double crochet row all the way to the end. Remember to yarn over, grab your yarn, and put it through that very first space. The space right underneath your chain, right there. That's where you want to be. This is going to keep the side of your work straight. Now make a half double crochet in every stitch across. Keep in mind, if you haven't gotten very good at the stitch yet, you need to stop here. You need to practice. Get really good at the stitch and then come back and make the scarf. And people will be really impressed to find out that you were able to make your own accessories. Okay, so keep doing that all the way to the end of the row and I will meet you there. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and do the very last stitch, and you're going to find that V again right here at the top. Let's see if I can do this. My light's not that great. You have your V stitch right here, okay, here and here. Make sure that you grab your yarn, yarn over, and find that space right up underneath the V stitch, okay? Get your yarn, pull it through all three loops, okay? So this is going to be the pattern for the entire scarf. Make sure at the end of every row that you chain two, turn your work, and work your half double crochets all the way to the following end. Chain two, turn your work, and do the same thing all the way back for every single row. Your scarf will look similar to this. Let me see if I can get it in the frame here. And of course, like the first picture I showed you at the beginning of the video, that is what your scarf will look like. Here it is, made complete. Okay, that is a complete scarf. Now what I did, this is an infinity scarf. What you can do is you can make the scarf as long as you want it and add tassels to the end. I'm sure there are videos online that show you how to make tassels, attach tassels to the ends of your scarves. Also, you can bring the two ends together and you can sew it together. That is completely up to you, whatever you decide. You'll notice that when I sew the two ends of the scarf together to make it an infinity scarf, you'll see a very slight seam right here. Okay, it's not very, very noticeable, but you will have a little bit of a seam. The nice thing about this particular seam is that it's raised like other areas of the scarf are raised, like this. So it's not too terribly noticeable. To sew your scarf together, you're going to need a darning needle or a yarn needle. Now in the next part of the tutorial, I'm going to show you how to sew together your scarf. Once you finish your scarf, you're going to need to get a pair of good scissors and cut a nice long strand of yarn. All right. When you get to the end of your scarf and you're ready to sew it together, make sure that you bring the yarn that you just cut through this top loop and pull it all the way through, just like that. Find the other end of your yarn and thread it through your needle, just like this. Okay, now you're going to need the two ends of your scarf. You're going to need to bring them together. Now this is just a little swatch that I created that I was making with you guys. I'm going to pretend that this side and this side are both the ends of my scarf, okay? What you're going to do is bring the two ends together like this. You need to find the side where your yarn is still connected, which is over here. And you are going to hold the two ends like this, okay? Your needle is going to go through the very, very first stitch. So think about like if you were going to put your hook back through a stitch or through a space to make a stitch. You're going to go right inside that same space. Okay? You're going to pull it through like this. Now, if you are someone who knows how to sew or is used to sewing, we're not going to whip stitch this back and forth like in and then around and in and then around. We're not going to do that. What we're going to do is go through underneath these stitches here. We want to make sure we get up underneath the V. Okay, that's very, very important. This way, if we do it this way, it's going to make sure not to show a big seam. All right, so we're going to go through the next V. We're going to go through this V stitch now and pull it through. I do apologize if this isn't in frame, you guys. All right. And then we're going to go past. We're not going to go around and come through the back. We're going to go through the front this way, right underneath the other V. Okay. Now it's going to be like lacing a shoelace. Come back this way underneath that next V on this side and pull. And then we're going to go up underneath the next V on the other side going this direction. Okay, so back this direction through the next V, or underneath the next V, and then this direction under the V on the other side. And we're just going to keep doing this just like this. This is going to ensure that you don't have a huge seam that's going to show and it's going to look kind of unprofessional. Okay, and then you do this all the way to the end and I will show you what the result looks like. Okay, so we're getting toward the very last part here. I did turn it sideways. This makes it a little bit easier for me, but you know what's going on, so. Okay, and we're getting to the very end. We need to go through this side here, right where that other piece of yarn is still. Okay, you've got this other piece of yarn that's your starting yarn. Now what you want to do, take the yarn off the needle, or the needle off the yarn, however you want to say that, and you're going to want to get and take the two yarn pieces and you want to tie them. You don't want to tie them tight, but you want to make sure they come together nicely. Okay, and you want to double knot that. All right, now, this looks a little silly, I know. But anyway, so now you have a beautiful seam that doesn't show up as a seam. It looks like you stitched it together with your hook, like you just made another row. Okay? Now what I want to show you is how to sew in your ends. In crocheting and knitting, we like to hide the ends of the yarn within our work. Some people, when they crochet, they just crochet around the strand of yarn. Some people like to wait and sew it in at the end, and that's usually what I do. I sew it in because I know for a fact that it won't come undone when I do it that way. So what you want to do is re-thread your yarn needle, and you need to find a space here where you can kind of go into the yarn. That's the great thing about having all of this, all these stitches here. You can go through the stitches with your needle and pull your yarn through, and it hides it. You'll never see it. Now, the one thing you'll want to do is when you're working on your scarf, make sure that you turn the scarf inside out, okay? Right now, this scarf, my scarf here, this is right side out, okay? You can see a little bit of the seaming. You want to turn it inside out like this, or go to the underneath side of the scarf. Whatever part of the scarf, whatever side of the scarf you're going to wear on the outside, you don't want to hide your yarn on that side. Actually, I kind of like this side better. I think what I'm going to do is take the side with the seam, and I'm going to use that. So take the side with the seam and go through and sew your yarn in. All right, here's how we do that. All right, so get up underneath a piece of yarn. Find a spot here where you can go in, just like that. Now pull it kind of tight, not too tight, but just kind of tight. Okay. Now what you want to do is find a space, like a stitch. You want to go up underneath the stitching, like this. You want to kind of find a space where you can go in. And when you do this, you're not going to see the yarn. The yarn is going to be hidden. That's one of the greatest things about using one color. If you have two colors, you have to be careful where you hide your yarn. With one solid color, that's not a problem. So just find spaces to work your yarn through, like this. Get up underneath your yarn, in between the stitches. Don't go all the way through, but just be underneath some of the stitches. And then what you're going to do is going to go back the other direction. You want to make sure this doesn't come unraveled. So go back up underneath the other pieces that you just were under and go the opposite direction, just like this. Okay. And then you're going to do it again. Okay. Make sure that you get some of the strand in there. You want to make sure it's well hidden. Go back through like this, up underneath these stitches again. I like to do it three times because it really keeps it from unraveling. I've never had anything unravel on me before, so whatever choice I made for that was a good one. Okay, so right about there, that's good. Okay, kind of pull it, make sure you got some give there. Get your scissors and cut that piece of yarn right here. Be careful not to cut your work because you cannot repair it once you do that. Okay, so then we're going to do the exact same thing to the next piece of yarn here. All right, we're going to hide the strand just like we did the other one. Just like the other one. We'll even go into the same space. It's not a big deal. Okay, and then go back the other direction. Just like the last one. You get really good at this after a while, so you pretty soon you won't have to think about it. You'll just do it. Okay, and you hidden your yarn. Come over here and cut it off, and you are finished. And now you have a finished piece. And it's actually beautiful on. I used a larger size hook specifically to make this more of a chunky scarf. A larger hook is also going to make your stitches larger, which means when you make your initial chain to start out your project, it's already going to be much wider than it would be than if you had used a much thinner hook. that would bring the size of your stitches down to about to here. You'd only have this much across. But with the larger hook, you have that extra width across, and so it makes the scarf larger. Thank you for watching this tutorial. If you have any questions, please leave your questions in the comments below. If you like this video, please hit the like button below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so, so that you'll get notifications for every one of the tutorials that we do in the future. Thank you again for joining us on the Crochet Depot. Have a great day.